Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Last week, a few weeks back, I can't remember when I posted it, I did a video all about a celebrity skincare only skincare routine. And this week it's the influencer's turn. Today I'm going to be using skincare products from influencer brands that I actually like. And then one at the end, I'm going to kind of like do my first impressions because I've seen everybody loves this. It's a brand I really like, so I want to try it as well. So let's get into it. I want to start off with Naturium. Naturium is of course Susan Yara's brand, and it's been years since the launch of Naturium. And as we all know, I've not reviewed this brand since it launched. I think a lot of people had a few issues with the way it was launched, and I want to say my piece on it because it has been a very, very long time. And this is kind of coming from reviewing brands as a whole, delving into brands as a whole, not just when we're talking about Naturium. The more I delve into these, every single brand, these big, huge conglomerates, my choices on how I purchase skincare from where and from who has changed massively. And whilst I still believe everyone should have a choice to speak out against brands who do things that they feel is problematic, I feel like there's a bit of a lack of consistency there, including with myself, with calling out brands for their problematic history, problematic currents, and possible futures. I've taken a personal decision to start reviewing Naturium because for me, in the grand scheme of things, it's a brand whose initial early issues I can forgive and forget and move on from. Compared to other brands who, in my opinion, have more problematic histories, problematic CEOs, problematic practices in general. These are other brands that other people seem absolutely okay to buy, and that's absolutely fine. If you choose not purchase products from a brand because it doesn't fit with your morals and your moral compass, then good, more power to you. That's exactly how I think you should use a purchasing power. But in general, as I mentioned, and not just related to the launch of Naturium, there's a lot of hypocrisy? I don't know how you say that, around surrounding boycotting brands that I've been guilty of too. If you watch back my videos like brands I'll never support or brands I'll never review, I stopped doing those videos for so many reasons. For example, we all know I won't use Nivea because of their homophobic comments. We all know I won't review DHC because of their racist CEO. I don't want those people benefiting from my money. But there are times I've missed stuff. For example, the year before the launch of Naturium, the Ordinary CEO at the time suggested a black lady on Instagram should lighten her skin with one of the Ordinary's products, whilst also unlawfully laying off a load of their staff. Yet everyone seemed to turn a blind eye, including myself. I didn't know what happened. As I said, I'm guilty of this too, but I do feel if I'm going to sit here and call out brands, I should do my research when it comes to every single brand. Now, of course, that CEO, rest in peace, isn't CEO or the company anymore, so it's a brand I can support again. But again, I feel that is very different to the launch of Naturium on my moral compass. As I said, I feel like if you're going to sit here and call out brands, especially if you were an influencer, a content creator, I don't feel like an average everyday consumer should have to research every single brand that they buy, right? Not everybody has that luxury, especially if they're buying drugstore, of being able to pick and choose what they can use and what they can afford based on their morals and ethics. But I do feel as content creators, we do have a responsibility to research the brands that we're talking about. For example, I was sent a video of an influencer, a skinfluencer, who did a whole think piece on Naturium, saying how bad the launch was and how are people still supporting this. Then they went on to review products from a brand that posted a video containing Asian racial slurs. That is a brand, for example, that I will no longer support and can't get behind. The racism, for example, is much higher on things I don't want to support than the launch of Naturium. Again, on my personal moral compass. Can we forgive and forget? Yes, of course, it's up to you what you forgive and forget. I feel like this is like Sunday Riley, right? Everybody loves their new jeans, good jeans, serum, yet they had this whole fake review scandal, but most people moved on because they love their product. And at the end of the day, what I'll say is do whatever's best for you. I won't be in your comments section in the replies telling you who you should and shouldn't use, but just do what's best for you and do what you want to do. On that note, my first favorite is actually from Naturium, the Niacinamide Cleansing Gelée 3%. My favorite cleansers was a mix between Selfless by Hyrum cleanser and Crave Beauty's cleanser. Cleansers that I really, really love, and in a way are all kind of similar, but there's something about the texture of this one and the way it leaves my skin feeling after that kind of puts this one above the rest for me. They say this is an innovative essence-like niacinamide cleanser. It is incredibly light and really is just a really nice niacinamide cleanser that cleanses without stripping your skin, leaves you feeling soft, and over time my skin just looks happy and feels refreshed. Now, I have only just cracked this one open again, but I first used this like, what, a year ago when Susan, bless her, was still sending me PR, even though she knew I wasn't reviewing the products. And I absolutely loved it. Love this so, so much. My skin always looks brighter, looks happier, looks less congested and stressed. You only need a tiny bit. It creates such a nice lather over the skin, which you then rinse away. A little bit readers go a long way with this. It's well worth the money. I also like to use this on dry skin, especially where it's been really hot and humid here. I don't really want to put like a balmy oil on my skin. So this is like a really nice lightweight alternative to removing all that sunscreen, lathering up, rinsing away, and then I go in with another cleanse. Let's move on to toner. This is a brand I hadn't heard of before, but I'm really starting to like their products. This is MGB Skin, which stands for something that I can't remember now. Let me have a look. I've got a file of facts. And this is by the influencer Meg Baby. And her brand is so nice. It's all like mugwort, ceramides, hydrating, soothing, moisturizing, calming. And this mist has been a really nice one, just kind of like rehydrate between each step. If you don't like fragrant skincare, you're not gonna like this because it's got, I don't know how to explain the scent of this. It's very nicely light, almost floral actually, but very soft, very delicate. And of course, mugwort being its main thing is very, very nice at soothing irritated skin. Again, during the hot weather, when my skin just feels like, oh, this has been nice and soothing and calming. And alongside a few other products I've been trying, has really helped revive my skin after trying a few skincare products more recently that my skin just really didn't like. This does have witch hazel in, which I actually really, really love. It kind of helps like balance out my sebum. And of course, just helps prep your skin for the next step. Next up, we have So Good, and this is by Sue Beauty Feel So Calm Toner Pad. She's a very popular, mainly skincare YouTuber from Korea, who I'm pretty sure we'd all recognize. And this product's really interesting to me because whilst I have come across cabbage as an ingredient in some skincare, I never come across it as kind of like the main one. And this contains 83% cabbage leaf water. Now, the cabbage leaf water is supposedly calming and soothing. And again, with these, I lost my little thing for these. And these are so nice. Again, like most pads, you kind of have a very, very slightly textured one side and then a super smooth other side. And they just kind of glide on the skin with very minimal friction. I kind of use this as like my main toner. I don't really count this as an exfoliation stage like you do with some pads. Again, it's fragrance free. If you don't like fragrance, you will love these. If you do like fragrance, you gotta love these too. So as I mentioned, the cabbage leaf is extremely soothing and calming, but then we also have aloe vera. Aloe leaf, again, really calming, soothing. One of my go-tos to help hydrate my skin. Centella, a nice antioxidant, calming, soothing again. Green tea, another antioxidant. Centella, really nice and calming and soothing. Green tea, a great antioxidant, again, calming and soothing. And you know what? They're just slightly bigger than your usual pad, which I really like because they cover such a big area. Like, yeah, I could just kind of like do one swipe across my forehead. And then when I'm feeling particularly irritated, you can just kind of like leave it on your skin and it covers such a huge area as almost like a soothing mask. But overall, I have found that these pads have been incredibly soothing. And what I love about this as well is it's soaked in a serum, in this like cabbage water, but it's not dripping. Like a lot of pads, you pull them out and they're dripping everywhere and you have to like quickly put it on your skin and wipe it around. These 100% cotton pads seem to hold in that serum so, so well. And you just get a really good dose of that serum. Well, actually, they call it a calming essence. But yeah, I've kind of been using this as like, as I mentioned, like my toner essence stage. They're so good. They're huge. So yeah, love these a lot. They're on Style Korean as well, so I'm able to like get them shipped over. Whereas a lot of this I have to do through like Naturium, for example, I have to do from a like shipping app where they give me an American address and then I kind of like, you know, forward it to my address. So these are really easy to get your hands on as well. Let's go into the serum. Now, I mentioned before that I'm not really into retinols right now. There's a few that I really, really like, including the COSRX retinol. And I'm absolutely loving the Selfless by Hyrum Retinol and Rainbow Algae Serum. So I personally love algae as like a moisturizing ingredient. Then we have tranexamic acid in here as well, which is one of my favorite ingredients to help even out skin tone. Mainly hyperpigmentation. And then we have squalane in here as well, which is a really nice moisturizing ingredient without it being like oily and sticky and heavy and greasy, which is great for people with oily skin. So we have 2% encapsulated retinol complex in here, which is a slow release gentle retinol to help smooth skin and even skin tone. And long story short, it makes it a lot gentler on the skin, me being rosacea prone, I have very sensitive skin when it comes to, oh God, when it comes to a lot of retinols, but I did discover I'm just trying to do too much. I was trying to like go up the ranks with the percentages, even though I know like bigger isn't always better, in some cases it is. But for me, around the 1% mark is perfect for me when it comes to retinol. But again, it's one of those serums, I just like the way it looks on my skin. Like it could have just been like a rainbow algae serum for me and I'd still use it. Do you know what I mean? Because it's nicely moisturizing, it feels good on the skin, it looks good on my skin. And as I mentioned, it's one of my more copable retinols. So I really like that one. I mean, honestly, that and the cleanser are the only products I use from the Selfless by Hyrynn range, because they just integrate into my routine so easily. Next up, we have a brand from Sarah Chung, and that is Sachu. I love the tools for this. Even if I don't use them properly, I just love pressing them on my rosacea prone skin. It calms and cools down my skin. I absolutely love it. This is a weird serum, I'm not gonna lie, but I like it. Let me explain why. So this is the Slick Skin Essential Lipid Serum. This was really made to work alongside the tools, so you can glide them over your skin without pulling or any irritation. But what we have in here is lipids and ceramides. So it's really, really helping with our skin barrier, restore, protect, squalane, helping to moisturize the skin. It does kind of give you like this silky smooth feeling on the skin, which I don't usually like. And it's in this huge pipette look, like massive. So I just kind of like let it drip on my hand, to be honest with you. At first, it feels like a really heavy oil. You're like, oh no, this is going to be so bad. But what this is amazing at is giving you this like dewy glow without any kind of oiliness or greasiness. So if you are oily, but you want like this dewy glass skin kind of look, but you're frightened that later during the day, your oily skin might make it worse. Do you know what I mean? Like your hydration levels are up, you've got your moisturizer on, but you're a little bit nervous that your oily skin is just gonna get oilier throughout the day. This is a great serum to kind of counteract that, because it looks really glossy and shiny, yet it feels sleek and smooth and not sticky in any way. It's really weird, I'll be honest, it's odd. Like when I first used it, I was like, I'm confused. I'm like, why does the texture not match the look? Like all of it sounds heavy, lipids, ceramides, squalane, it sounds heavy, but it just gives me such a nice, natural looking glow that I really, really love. And I'm big on ceramides at the moment, especially in my evening routines, because I just want to repair my skin and keep my skin constantly happy all the time. Now I'm gonna go in. A lot of people have asked me for an update on Nymia by Nikki Tutorials. And I'll be honest, I don't think much of the brand. Like I use the products up and I won't be buying them again, but I do love the eye stick. I think it's a great kind of like makeup prep product, but as skincare standalone, that's kind of it. I'm just kind of doing this because I don't have anything for the eyes. But as far as like an update on that goes, I don't use Nymia as a brand. I don't think it's a skincare brand alone. I think it's great makeup prep. But other than this, I've not really been using. Like this is literally by the side of my bed. I got on these little hangy cubby things and occasionally I'll just be like this. And that's kind of it. Do I notice long-term results of this? Not really. Eye creams are obviously much better. There's bits left of me now. But as far as an update, I don't use the products. I won't be buying more going forward. I have a bit of a surprise for you. I decided to buy myself some products from Wishful Skin because I have tried a few and I was sent a few. I've never wanted to try it. I've always been a bit like, about the brand. For me, it's kind of like the language they use within their marketing that makes it sound like they come up with all these amazing new innovations when it's all just like rebranded K-beauty kind of thing. That's what it feels like to me. But I saw this Wishful Honey Balm Jelly Moisturizer, and the word jelly moisturizer kind of really speaks to me. A lot of people think I have an issue with Huda herself. I don't. I really don't know anything about her, to be honest, other than she is a successful businesswoman who had a dodgy eyeshadow palette one time. But let me read you a bit about this. So they say that this is dewy, glassy, gorgeous skin, a luxurious textured jelly meets balm moisturizer, infused with honey to lock in moisture for up to 24 hours, packed with honey, turmeric root, niacinamide, and unfortunately lavender. I just don't like the smell of lavender. But the honey, turmeric root, and niacinamide sounds really good to me as far as like moisturizing the skin, making the skin look nice from the outside, helping with the pores and sebum production. It is unbearably lavender. It's getting your nan some like bath smellies kind of lavender, you know? But I don't know if you can see, I'll try and, it has like this pearlescence to it, which of course is mica. We also have some watermelon fruit extract in here, which is a nice antioxidant. Other than that, It's a pretty basic moisturizer. It looks pretty full, but you just need like a little bit like this. And it does add, because of the mica, it adds like this glow that doesn't look like glitter. I know mica and glitter aren't the same thing, but you know, it all looks the same to me. Like that. It's a shame it smells like lavender. I just don't like lavender. I don't really think a calming essential oil is kind of like interests me. To me, it's kind of like cool, like saying we've got some dry rain. But as far as moisturizers go, I've really been enjoying this, and I've been using this under like tinted sunscreens just to give me the extra boost. This by all means hasn't been my daily go-to moisturizer, but I like the glow that it gives me under a sunscreen, under a tinted sunscreen, sorry, as they all tend to be quite mattifying. But I really, really like the look that this gives my skin. Ooh, a little bit dewier than most people like, but as I said, it's teamed up with a sunscreen, which is what I'm gonna try next. Where is it? This is the Summer Fridays Shade Drops Mineral Milk Sunscreen. I didn't know this was an influencer brand at all. So Mariana Hewitt and Lauren Gores Island, I'm not sure. I think are both influencer. I've followed Mariana Hewitt for a long time, and I knew who the founder was, and I just thought she was popular because of this, but she's an influencer. But yeah, this is their latest sunscreen, I believe. SPF 30, UVA, UVB. And this is a brand who I absolutely love. Like, I love their products, but I only ever review them when I'm doing a sponsored post. But they always send me stuff to try, and then I try it, and they're like, do you want to do a sponsored post if you like it? I'm like, yeah, I love it. So they say that this is enriched with vitamins and antioxidants. This lightweight mineral sunscreen glides over the skin like a serum, delivering SPF and skincare benefits. Soothing chamomile, reef-friendly, form to help shield skin from UVA, UVB rays, and leave skin with a soft, natural finish. Okay. They say it's for all skin tones. I'm very light skinned. I'm lighter on the tanned section, so this is gonna be fine on me probably. Let's give it a go. Oh, it's a little bit beige. It's got like a beigey finish to it. What I'm looking for is no white cast, no smell. That's nice. Oh, I do like this so far. That feels nice. Oh, I really like this. This is nice for a mineral sunscreen. Nearly every mineral sunscreen I use instantly mattifies my skin. It gets caught in my eyebrows and makes them white, and I have like white in my beard line, and this is nice. I'll put it on my eyes and I'll tell if it stung later. I'll put it here. Did it sting? I'll let you know if it stings throughout the day. I'm not gonna use it on my neck because I'm not actually going anywhere, and I'm inside with the curtains drawn today, so I won't be going anywhere. I like that. I actually like that a lot. That is nice. Yep. All skin tones, I'll have to check with other people, but for me, that this works so nice. I've seen people complain about the size of it, but we all use those like really amazing Japanese sunscreens that are like this. That Pikachu one there is tiny. I really, really like that. Right, let's end on lips. This is actually a makeup brand. This is Manny MUA's Luna Beauty. And whenever I go and film with my brother Robert, who does makeup, if you don't know already, we sit at his desk and there's usually makeup everywhere before we film for our joint channel. And I always need a lip product, and he always gives me the Luna Beauty ones because I like a little color. I like a little bit of gloss, and I like a heavy but not sticky feeling. So not heavy, but comforted and nourished feeling without stickiness. This is the Divine Lip Gloss. They call it the lip gloss to end all glosses. The Luna Beauty Lip Gloss feels weightless on the lips like a hydrating lip treatment, provides the most amazing glossy lip finish. And it does. This is Divine Lip. They say it's sheer baby doll pink with a silver reflect. We've got jojoba seed oil, shea butter, and some colors. I really like this. Hang on. I just do one lip. Give it a little wipe over. Ta-da! And my lips feel like really cared for, nourished, glossy, without being too much. Obviously the lights always make everything look like a little bit shinier and a little bit glossy than it actually is. With a nice flavor, without feeling heavy and suffocating on the lips. But I love this. I had to get my own because I was like using Robert's, and I absolutely love them. The other eye product I of course would have mentioned is Dew. Charlotte's brand. If you don't follow her over on TikTok, especially already, for amazing, not just skincare tips, but kind of like insider industry information as well. You have to check her out. I don't use TikTok that much, but I'm over there strictly to watch hers and a few others' videos. But I've talked about you of reusable eye patches to death. But yeah, absolutely love these. So there we go. There is a full face of influencer skincare brands that I actually really, really like. I think a good thing about influencers who launch products is that they kind of know they've been doing it for years, and comments is always feedback. It's like free, kind of like crowdsourcing. Is that the word? Consumer feedback. So they kind of know what they feel is missing here and there. Sure, there are some flops and there are some really good hits as well. So let me know what you think about some of these products down below if you've tried any of these brands. You can watch some more skincare reviews here, some general light entertainment here. They'll see you over there.